everyone, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to share my hair oiling routine. Before we start this video, I have a request to all of you. YouTube tells me that more than 90% people watching my videos are not subscribed to my channel. So if you think I deserve it and if you like my videos, please do subscribe. It's completely free to you, but it means a lot to me and really helps me do better. And it helps me grow and create better content. And also, we are so close to 10,000 subscribers. And once we hit that, I'm gonna do an exciting giveaway. So if you don't want to miss that, please consider subscribing. And also, please give this video a thumbs up so that I know you guys are enjoying this video, so that I can make more such videos. Because if you guys are not enjoying this, I might as well do some different kind of videos which you might like. So yeah, please consider subscribing and liking this video. And now, without further ado, let's get started. Today's comment shout out goes to Sabrina. Thank you so much for the comment. Most of you must be knowing, hair oiling is so good for your hair. It gives nourishment to your hair, it gives strength and adds moisture in the hair and all that good stuff. So I basically oil my hair once a week, because I wash my hair once a week. So I would apply the oil before washing my hair. Honestly, I haven't applied hair oil since the past few months because of laziness. You know, we all have our days. And I noticed a huge difference. My hair just looks more frizzy than before. My hair looked so healthy back in December or Jan. I was just going through my old videos and I saw a huge difference. So I'm again back to it, and I'm gonna try to consistently apply hair oil every week. So for this video, I mixed coconut oil and castor oil. Usually I apply either of the two. I don't mix oils, but I recently came to know that mixing oils can be really beneficial. So that's why I showed this in the video. So I'm taking a little bit of oil, not too much. You can even mix it in a container, but I feel if you mix it in a container, the quantity just becomes too much and you also end up applying too much, and I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to mix it on my hands and later add more if required. You can even warm the oil if you want to. That's really good as well. And don't just apply oil for the sake of it. It won't do much for your hair other than just having a layer of oil. You have to actually massage your scalp so that it stimulates the blood flow, and it can also help with your hair fall and dandruff issues if you have. Not in all cases, but in most of the cases, this might work wonders. You can refer to some sites which tell different techniques to massage your hair. So really take your time out. You can do this for around 10 minutes. So what I basically do is, I first take the oil and I apply it on my entire scalp, and then I really start massaging on all points. Like, you can start with the front portion and then go towards the back, and also the area near your ears, you can really massage it. And you know guys, just take your time massaging each and every point. It's really beneficial for your hair health, and it even calms your mind and it relaxes you. And if you're doing this at night, then even better, because it helps you sleep better. And don't apply too much of the oil. Earlier, I should literally drench my hair in oil because I thought it's better for my hair. I should literally apply oil like this and, you know, like literally drench it. It used to look wet with the oil, and I would also comb it out so that it's like spread evenly. But don't do that. I noticed my hair didn't look the best when I did that. It actually looked frizzy, and probably the reason for that is when you actually focus the oil on each hair strand, you tend to go with more shampoo just to remove the oil buildup, and that is more drying for your hair because you're applying more shampoo to remove more moisture. So that's just not good for you to do it regularly. You can do it once in a while, like once in a few months or once in a month if you really want to, but regularly is just not healthy for your hair. So just focus the oil on your scalp, and later whatever oil is left on your hands, you can choose to apply this on the lengths of your hair. Don't add extra oil on the lengths of your hair, because you're not supposed to apply shampoo there. You're just supposed to apply shampoo on your scalp and let the shampoo run with water through your hair, and that much shampoo is enough for the rest of your hair. You don't want to apply extra shampoo on the lengths. So just focus the oil on the scalp, massage it really well, and you can gently finger detangle if you want to. I don't really focus on detangling right now. I just focus on applying the oil. So it's fine if my hair is still tangled. I can deal with that later in the shower. So after applying the oil, you can leave it on for 1 to 2 hours, or you can leave it overnight. I usually leave it overnight because in the morning when I wash my hair, I just don't have that much time to apply oil and then wait. I just don't like to sit for long when I don't have bath, because when I do that, I end up not having bath. I either have bath very early in the morning, soon after waking up, or not at all. There's no in between. So it depends on your personal preference. If you wash your hair at night, then in the evening you can apply oil and then let it be, and then after some time you can wash your hair. And when you let that oil stay in your hair, it gets absorbed nicely and it makes your hair soft and moisturized, so that later when you detangle, it's not that difficult and the detangling process is much easier because your hair is moisturized now. And also don't leave it on for too long, because that's also not good for your hair. And also don't go out after oiling, because all the dirt and everything is gonna get attracted, because oil is sticky, so it's gonna stick on your hair and again cause hair problems, you know, dandruff and everything. I remember when I was in school, it's actually ulta what happens. Like, other kids, they don't like oiling their hair and their moms are behind them like, oil your hair. But my case was completely opposite. I used to literally drench my hair in oil because I thought that's good for my hair. Like, not my whole school life, this was just for 1 year, you know, we all have different phases. I think it was in 9th standard. Like, I used to apply so much oil. My mom used to shout at me. She's like, don't use so much oil, you're just spoiling your hair, because it's attracting all the dirt and everything. And it gives you dandruff and hair fall and, you know, unnecessary bad stuff to your hair. And I should not listen to her. You know how teenagers are, right? So yeah, I'm telling with experience, don't put so much oil and go out. You can even steam your hair once in a while if you want to. I really don't have the patience to do that, but it's good for the hair, so you can do that. And if you're lazy like me, you can even take like hot showers before you wash your hair and let all that steam get absorbed. That also works well. And after you're done oiling the hair, just tie it in a loose bun. Don't make it too tight. Don't, you know, like comb and make a really tight bun, because your hair is more prone to breakage when you massage it. So just tie a loose bun so that it's nicely protected and the oil is doing its job. So that was my hair oiling routine. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. It really helps me a lot. I upload new videos every week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.